North Korea claims it has successfully tested a hydrogen bomb, a device which can be loaded onto a long-range ballistic missile. There's no independent verification of that claim. South Korea and Japan say it was a nuclear test 10 times more powerful than the previous attempt by Pyongyang.
조선민주주의인민공화국 핵무기 연구소 성명.
A jubilant newsreader on state TV announced that the bomb test had been a complete success. The device was of unprecedentedly large power, she said. The news came just hours after state media published this photograph of Kim Jong-un apparently inspecting such a device. The test comes against a backdrop of heightened tension in the region following multiple missile launches by North Korea, the last one conducted less than a week ago. Earlier, seismologists detected a powerful tremor measuring 6.3 near the North's main testing site at Punggye-ri. Well, let's talk now to Lasina Zerbo from the Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty Organization. Good morning to you. What do you see as the significance of this?
Good morning. I think at 3:30 this morning, as you mentioned, our international monitoring system of station detected a significant event much larger than the previous announced and declared a DPRK test. And this is clearly an indication that the program is going increasingly serious and that the international community needs to come up pretty soon with a solution.
Increasingly serious, and it's going at some speed, you would say.
Indeed, because we move since 2006, that's now the sixth test, all detected by our international monitoring system, but this one is obviously much larger than the previous ones.
One of the questions here is whether or not what has been tested today, and they're talking about a hydrogen bomb, could be in some way linked to a long-range missile. Are you clear on that in your mind?
Look, I think what I would say is that whether it's a hydrogen bomb or not, what is evident today is that their program is increasingly getting serious in terms of their ability to master the technology of having a nuclear bomb. So we're not speculating at this moment whether it's an hydrogen bomb or not, because our role is to indeed to come with concise specification, technical specification for our member state, and this is what we're doing. And then we can just confirm that it's a much larger event than the previous one, and a good indication that they're progressing quite well.
In which case, what do you say the international community should do now?
I think sanction has been on and on. So if sanction were working, I think we wouldn't be at this stage. We've been advocating that since 2006, many of us, an expert including, I've been saying that it's about time to find a way to stop the DPRK from doing further tests. I think we're not there yet. Sanction has been going, but now we're talking about the sixth test. And then technically, experts are talking about the possibility of carrying further.
OK, thank you very much for your thoughts, Lasina Zerbo there in Vienna. Well, of course, China will be watching developments on the Korean Peninsula very carefully. Stephen McDonnell is in Beijing for us now. Any official reaction thus far, Stephen?
Yes, well, I should say straight off the bat, we have just received a brief written statement from the Chinese Foreign Ministry strongly condemning this latest nuclear weapons test. Now, just to give you an idea of how close this is to China, Yanji is a small city not far from the North Korean border, and on Chinese social media we've seen images of chandeliers shaking and the like from the power of this underground test being felt on Chinese territory. So people up there are certainly aware that it's happened. And you know what will not be lost on the Chinese government is that this is at least, well, the third time that I can count that either a nuclear or missile test has come out of North Korea to coincide with a really crucial diplomatic meeting that the Chinese government has had. And in this case, it's just opened up the BRICS summit, a very important meeting with Russia, India, Brazil, all who've all come to China. And this test comes to coincide with the opening of the meeting. This will infuriate the government in Beijing. And it looks like a bit of a, well, an indication from Pyongyang that it's not happy with China's imposition of sanctions on that country.
Stephen, good to have your thoughts. Thank you very much, Stephen. North Korea claims it has successfully tested a hydrogen bomb, a device which can be loaded onto a long-range ballistic missile. There's no independent verification of that claim. South Korea and Japan say it was a nuclear test 10 times more powerful than the previous attempt by Pyongyang.
조선민주주의인민공화국 핵무기 연구소 상명.
A jubilant newsreader on state TV announced that the bomb test had been a complete success. The device was of unprecedentedly large power, she said. The news came just hours after state media published this photograph of Kim Jong-un apparently inspecting such a device. The test comes against a backdrop of heightened tension in the region following multiple missile launches by North Korea, the last one conducted less than a week ago. Earlier, seismologists detected a powerful tremor measuring 6.3 near the North's main testing site at Punggye-ri. Well, let's talk now to Lasina Zerbo from the Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty Organization. Good morning to you. What do you see as the significance of this?
Good morning. I think at 3:30 this morning, as you mentioned, our international monitoring system of station detected a significant event much larger than the previous announced and declared DPRK test. And this is clearly an indication that the program is going increasingly serious and that the international community needs to come up pretty soon with a solution.
Increasingly serious, and it's going at some speed, you would say.
Indeed, because we move since 2006, that's now the sixth test, all detected by our international monitoring system, but this one is obviously much larger than the previous ones.
One of the questions here is whether or not what has been tested today, and they're talking about a hydrogen bomb, could be in some way linked to a long-range missile. Are you clear on that in your mind?
Look, I think what I would say is that whether it's a hydrogen bomb or not, what is evident today is that their program is increasingly getting serious in terms of their ability to master the technology of having a nuclear bomb. So we're not speculating at this moment whether it's an hydrogen bomb or not, because our role is to indeed to come with concise specification, technical specification for our member state, and this is what we're doing. And then we can just confirm that it's a much larger event than the previous one, and a good indication that they're progressing quite well.
In which case, what do you say the international community should do now?
I think sanction has been on and on. So if sanction were working, I think we wouldn't be at this stage. We've been advocating that since 2006, many of us, an expert including, I've been saying that it's about time to find a way to stop the DPRK from doing further tests. I think we're not there yet. Sanction has been going, but now we're talking about the sixth test. And then technically, experts are talking about the possibility of carrying further.
OK, thank you very much for your thoughts, Lasina Zerba there in Vienna. Well, of course, China will be watching developments on the Korean Peninsula very carefully. Stephen McDonnell is in Beijing for us now. Any official reaction thus far, Stephen?
Yes, well, I should say straight off the bat, we have just received a brief written statement from the Chinese Foreign Ministry strongly condemning this latest nuclear weapons test. Now, just to give you an idea of how close this is to China, Yanji is a small city not far from the North Korean border, and on Chinese social media we've seen images of chandeliers shaking and the like from the power of this underground test being felt on Chinese territory. So people up there are certainly aware that it's happened. And you know what will not be lost on the Chinese government is that this is at least, well, the third time that I can count that either a nuclear or missile test has come out of North Korea to coincide with a really crucial diplomatic meeting that the Chinese government has had. And in this case, it's just opened up the BRICS summit, a very important meeting with Russia, India, Brazil, all who've all come to China. And this test comes to coincide with the opening of the meeting. This will infuriate the government in Beijing. And it looks like a bit of a, well, an indication from Pyongyang that it's not happy with China's imposition of sanctions on that country.
Stephen, good to have your thoughts. Thank you very much, Stephen. North Korea claims it has successfully tested a hydrogen bomb, a device which can be loaded onto a long-range ballistic missile. There's no independent verification of that claim. South Korea and Japan say it was a nuclear test 10 times more powerful than the previous attempt by Pyongyang.
조선민주주의인민공화국 핵무기 연구소 상명.
A jubilant newsreader on state TV announced that the bomb test had been a complete success. The device was of unprecedentedly large power, she said. The news came just hours after state media published this photograph of Kim Jong-un apparently inspecting such a device. The test comes against a backdrop of heightened tension in the region following multiple missile launches by North Korea, the last one conducted less than a week ago. Earlier, seismologists detected a powerful tremor measuring 6.3 near the North's main testing site at Punggye-ri. Well, let's talk now to Lasina Zerbo from the Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty Organization. Good morning to you. What do you see as the significance of this?
Good morning. I think at 3:30 this morning, as you mentioned, our international monitoring system of station detected a significant event much larger than the previous announced and declared DPRK test. And this is clearly an indication that the program is going increasingly serious and that the international community needs to come up pretty soon with a solution.
Increasingly serious, and it's going at some speed, you would say.
Indeed, because we move since 2006, that's now the sixth test, all detected by our international monitoring system, but this one is obviously much larger than the previous ones.
One of the questions here is whether or not what has been tested today, and they're talking about a hydrogen bomb, could be in some way linked to a long-range missile. Are you clear on that in your mind?
Look, I think what I would say is that whether it's a hydrogen bomb or not, what is evident today is that their program is increasingly getting serious in terms of their ability to master the technology of having a nuclear bomb. So we're not speculating at this moment whether it's an hydrogen bomb or not, because our role is to indeed to come with concise specification, technical specification for our member state, and this is what we're doing. And then we can just confirm that it's a much larger event than the previous one, and a good indication that they're progressing quite well.
In which case, what do you say the international community should do now?
I think sanction has been on and on. So if sanction were working, I think we wouldn't be at this stage. We've been advocating that since 2006, many of us, an expert including, I've been saying that it's about time to find a way to stop the DPRK from doing further tests. I think we're not there yet. Sanction has been going, but now we're talking about the sixth test. And then technically, experts are talking about the possibility of carrying further.
OK, thank you very much for your thoughts, Lasina Zerba there in Vienna. Well, of course, China will be watching developments on the Korean Peninsula very carefully. Stephen McDonnell is in Beijing for us now. Any official reaction thus far, Stephen?
Yes, well, I should say straight off the bat, we have just received a brief written statement from the Chinese Foreign Ministry strongly condemning this latest nuclear weapons test. Now, just to give you an idea of how close this is to China, Yanji is a small city not far from the North Korean border, and on Chinese social media we've seen images of chandeliers shaking and the like from the power of this underground test being felt on Chinese territory. So people up there are certainly aware that it's happened. And you know what will not be lost on the Chinese government is that this is at least, well, the third time that I can count that either a nuclear or missile test has come out of North Korea to coincide with a really crucial diplomatic meeting that the Chinese government has had. And in this case, it's just opened up the BRICS summit, a very important meeting with Russia, India, Brazil, all who've all come to China. And this test comes to coincide with the opening of the meeting. This will infuriate the government in Beijing. And it looks like a bit of a, well, an indication from Pyongyang that it's not happy with China's imposition of sanctions on that country.
Stephen, good to have your thoughts. Thank you very much, Stephen.